hauled the fence gate wide open that night, put my pistol in my lap, drank myself into a stupor. My life was over, and Maggie's death was my fault. As I'd heard the things chitter, I'd caught sight of something big, skittering through the tall grass, started to see the trends. I even kicked up a ruckus that it weren't no wild animal that took our boy Seth, only 12 years old, disappeared from a Boy Scout camp 5 miles away. Nobody believed. I didn't take Maggie and run. I weren't taken. The funny thing, the booze and the pistol, well, they were. Well, not far, but it wasn't me. Maggie's spirit? Oh, she'd have had my hide for shooting myself. But no, it was that thing, like a what you call it, hypnotist implanted idea. It wasn't gonna kill me. It didn't want me to blow my brains out because it wanted something. It needed something. It didn't bother tell me what, but the want was clear. So as hell as each day would be. For Maggie, for Seth, Lucky, and all the other folk. I had to stick around.